Veena's New Idea by Asha Nehemia. Aunt Malu should have refused to try out Veena's new idea. Trying out her 9-year-old niece's ideas always landed Aunt Malu in trouble. One time, Veena had got her to try the Adopt a Pet plan. This was a wonderful plan that found homes for wounded animals. Aunt Malu couldn't decide which of the pets she adopted gave her more trouble, the myna with the broken wing or the lame mongoose. The myna could copy the sounds of a telephone ringing, the doorbell buzzing, and the pressure cooker whistling. So Aunt Malu kept rushing from kitchen to front door to telephone till she got so tired that she could barely stand. And the mongoose wouldn't stop stealing food from their neighbor's kitchen. The worst was the time Aunt Malu had agreed to make a pair of grass-cutting roller skates as a gift for Veena's father, Mr. Sheshadri. He was Aunt Malu's older brother. He loved gardening and was very proud of his lawn. It was the best lawn in the neighborhood. Veena had come up with the idea of fixing sharp blades onto a pair of skates. This meant that a person would be able to cut grass just by skating over it. It was an absolutely brilliant idea, if it worked. There was great excitement when the gift was put together and wrapped, but the skates were a total failure. To begin with, Mr. Sheshadri found it impossible to skate on the grass. He tripped and fell so many times that he was soon covered with cuts. He stopped trying to skate when he hit his forehead and was left with a bump, which became the color and size of one of his prize-winning brinjals. When Veena tried them on, she found that she could manage to skate over the grass, but instead of cutting the grass, the skates pulled out huge bunches of it. This left big, bald patches on Mr. Sheshadri's beautiful lawn. Mr. Sheshadri was not pleased. That's why Aunt Malu should have been more careful when Veena entered her workroom one morning and said,
"I have an idea."
Aunt Malu was so busy pounding red hibiscus petals for making her herbal medicines that she didn't hear Veena.
"What do you think about getting rich?"
Veena was a little louder. She pushed aside several tiny bottles with cork stoppers and tall jars made of thick blue-green glass so that she could sit on the table where her aunt was working. Veena could not sit still. She liked to swing her legs and fiddle with everything on the table. Sometimes, without thinking, she would mix up the seeds that Aunt Malu had just sorted out, or spill some precious drops of jasmine oil onto the table.
"Stop fiddling with the pineapple prickles. I've just washed and dried them. And don't sit on my table if you can't stop shaking it."
Aunt Malu was measuring out some shiny white cucumber seeds on a tiny weighing scale.
"I'm not sure I should try any more of your ideas, Veena,"
Malu said calmly.
"The last time I tried one of your ideas, I ended up spending 10 days in bed, not able to move at all."
"It was only 8 days, and it was just your arms you couldn't move,"
said Veena.
"Anyway, that's not going to happen this time. My idea for making you rich is going to be no trouble at all."
Even at this point, Aunt Malu could have been smart enough to change the topic, or to start talking about the weather, or the price of potatoes. Or wiser still, she should have run from the room as fast as her plump feet could carry her. Instead, she took a deep breath and asked,
"So, what do you have in mind this time?"
"My idea is simple,"
said Veena.
"Everyone knows you're a wizard with herbs and flowers, that you studied the ancient science of herbs from a holy man who spent 30 years up on a tree in the rainforests of Kerala. But only sick people or people with problems buy your herbal medicines. Now, if you could make some product that everyone, and not just sick people, would have to use, something like soap or face cream that almost everybody would have to use every day, then you'll make more money."
"But I've already tried that, Veena,"
Aunt Malu pointed out.
"I've already tried making herbal products that everyone can use. Remember the herbal laundry starch? And the voice-improving pills made from clove and peppermints? They were both such fantastic products, but no one bought them."
"That's because those two products were..."
Veena was not sure how to tell her aunt the truth. She thought for a bit and then went on.
Those two products were a little ahead of their time.
The truth was that the herbal laundry starch made saris and bed sheets so crisp and stiff that these lengths of cloth could actually stand upright on their own, like a tent without pegs. As for the voice-improving pills, that was another story. Yet Aunt Malu's Malu herbal cures were very popular. Some mornings their front gate was blocked by a long queue of people wanting to buy some herbal medicine or the other. Special favorites were the instant wart removers, the birthmark fading lotion, and the nail-growing cream that helped nails grow overnight. Another bestseller was the range of hair coloring oils. You just had to sleep with the tips of your hair dipped in the oil. There was also the popular inhaler that stopped people from snoring, and a sweet-smelling sachet that could be put under the pillow to stop people from having nightmares. Aunt Malu was in deep thought. She then said firmly,
"No, Veena. After all my years of special training, I don't want to make an ordinary product."
Aunt Malu turned down Veena's idea of becoming rich. She pushed the thoughts of swimming with dolphins and shaking hands with koalas out of her mind. To be able to afford such luxuries, she will have to make ordinary things like herbal soaps and face creams. And she will not do such low things. And so things continued just the way they were. She continued to eat ordinary food and do ordinary things, rice and sambar for every meal, and riding her old bicycle up winding mountain paths and through the fields of rice. No exotic holidays with dolphins and koalas for now.